Okay. Yeah. Hello, Satish.
Hello, Michael.
Yeah, nice to meet you here. And
yeah, me too.
Very glad about the last week we spent together.
Sure. Yeah, it was a nice time with you.
Yeah. So, so for the people to let, I'm Michael.
I'm Satish.
Yeah. So we met here in South India, in Tamil Nadu.
Yes.
Coincidentally, in Southern Forest, and Satish saw me and my wife practicing a Tai Chi form. Got attracted and kept asking for us to come around and share a little bit. And I was really surprised about this nice atmosphere of really true Kung Fu family, which you have already in your gym there here in Chennai. And about your openness to invite me to share about our Tai Chi here. And maybe you want to let us know a little bit about your background and how that came. So you're more into kickboxing and MMA, but now also the curiosity about a traditional Chinese martial art, the internal Kung Fu of Taiji. And you have some experience with Kalai, right?
Varimakalai,
yeah. Maybe you can tell us a little bit about all of that.
Okay. First, I have to tell about myself. I love martial artists. I love martial art. When I'm 10, my childhood, I start my martial art training. My first martial art training is karate. I am a big interested to martial art, to learn, and I am a normal kid. You know, when I plan to learn martial art, I want to become a strong in physically and mentally. I find only one make me change, that is martial art. Without martial art, I am not be strong person. After I learn karate and I get my black belt, and I participate a lot of tournament, and only one full contact tournament I won in karate. Maybe another sports karate I can't win, because sports karate rules is feather touch, but that is very difficult. That's one very difficult for me. Next, I have a very big plan, because I want to be a real martial artist. I want to be a real fighter. Boxing, I saw the boxing matches, and I have a lot of, I'm impressed. I looking for the boxing classes, and I joined with one good classes. I get very good master for boxing. He make me a good boxer, and that time karate, pure martial karate is the martial art family. Karate, boxing is not a martial art family, but it should be. But it's a different.
It's more sportive, right?
More sportive, like
yes,
that. Yeah.
Mm.
When I start my boxing, but I can't do boxing. You know, sometimes my kicks is coming.
Mm-hmm.
That is
we need to let the audience know that this is in the sport, there are rules, and boxing kicking is not allowed.
Yes, but boxing is only hand.
But in the martial art context of
kicks,
everything,
kicks is major for our role.
Yeah.
We use most we use kicks, because we are good for kicks in every martial artist.
Mm.
Very difficult for me, sometimes I lose my hope, boxing is not suitable for me, I will go back in karate. But in my inner peace tell me, this one is suitable for you, make your hard work and make some changes and dedicate yourself in that sort. Then I train more than hours, I spend more than hours. And also that one of the reason I'm a very, very bad study person. In my college, I'm only active in that sports and adventure like that. In study, no, I'm very, very low level. But after that, I be good, not a very good. I be good in boxing, and I get a medal in state level, and I made some record for the fastest knockout and 6 seconds for the state record.
State means the state of Tamil Nadu?
Yes, state of Tamil Nadu, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
At the same time, I have a chance to learn judo, because when I thought in 2009, 2010, that time, mixed martial arts is familiar for that time. Before, no one know that, because everybody know boxing and karate and different martial arts. MMA at that time very familiar, because two people, they are fighting in that cage, low rules, lot of injuries and real fights. But most of the people, they think this is that's very brutal. But you know, I don't know, that sports, you know, my eyes on that sports, and that sports, you know, pulling me to
pulls it to, yeah, to new challenges you.
Yeah.
And you to develop, yeah, further. Yes.
Yeah. Furtherly, I'm looking for that. I have a chances to first MMA training in here, Chennai, and I get some people there help me to learn judo, and I learn MMA. But I can't complete the matches because my financially I'm not stable that time. Then you know, I'm because in boxing, kickbox, my standing fighter, but MMA is not a standing game. MMA is fully 90%, 80% is a ground game. So only grappler is
ground.
Only grappler is dominate for MMA. Mm-hmm. Then you know, I get a very good master. He's not a master. He's my well-wisher. He's my very good. He's guide me very well in still my every time. In it, his name is C.S. Rajagopal. He's father of judo in South India. Mm-hmm. He teach me judo in very short time. I'll go and get a judo black belt. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, I'm practicing judo and also I'm practicing taekwondo. Taekwondo also I got the black belt, and both of it I went to the national level. And
so you collected all the black belts in those.
Yeah, I'm a six different martial art black belt. Yeah, in karate and judo, mm-hmm, akijitsu, mm-hmm, and K1 kickboxing, taekwondo, mm-hmm, and mm-hmm, silambam mm-hmm, also. Yeah, mm-hmm. Because you know, I use my every time for training. Yeah. Morning, if I morning train boxing, evening train I'm in judo, and weekend training go to taekwondo, and alternate is if I take time I'm doing katas in karate. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not waste my time.
So the karate always stayed with you.
Yeah, mm-hmm, because my first martial art is a karate martial art.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
I'm not forget anything. Yeah, mm-hmm, yeah, because this is on my muscle memory. That's mm-hmm, on my everything is, and. Then I have a chance to complete the Asian amateur MMA matches. This match taught me which level I am. You know,
mm-hmm,
I can find myself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I can find who I am.
Mm-hmm.
Before, I don't think so. Okay, I can't do. But then I recognize. Okay, I can do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, oh, because that mm-hmm match is the big Asian is the international match, but I easily get the gold medal for that match.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, then 1 month break. Muay Thai is new for me. Just one and a half month training. I going for Assam for attending the national amateur and professional Muay Thai championship. I got both match. I got gold medal and championship. I'm the first Tamil Nadu fighter,
mm-hmm,
won the pro champion in senior level, pro champion. I'm the first Tamil Nadu fighter. Before or next, I don't think anyone got that. Yeah, because mm-hmm Muay Thai is very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, after a while, that's my chapter going to, I will do boxing, I got that medal, and I'll do taekwondo, I got the medal, and I'm the MMA, yeah, this is my dream. My dream is I want to be MMA fighter in the successful in the pro level, and in the 2015, I am the first Tamil Nadu fighter will enter the MMA octagon to complete my pro amateur MMA championship in Bangalore. Then I won the national kickboxing tournament and selected for the Asian level kickboxing match in Pune. Chhatrapati Shivaji Stadium, August, that match 2016 August. Unfortunately, I don't get any sponsor, but you know, that match will confirm in the final day, before that day. But I tried, I just tried myself because mentally I'm not settled, but okay, I'll go to that match, I'll try hard. I'm facing, before I'm qualifying, I'm winning and semi-final. I'm meeting that Kyrgyzstan fighter. You know, it's a very tough match, very close match. He is winning that point.
Mm-hmm.
I lost, but that day I am going to the, you know, everybody is celebrating the winning. I got the bronze medal, but I'm not there in the stadium. I'm going to the on the lake, nearby the lake area, and I go to feel because I am representing India, but first my international, first my representing India for the very big match. But I know I lost my gold, you know. That make me, you know, make me good, not good. I not feel good. That time. I go to think about myself. You know, I'm not happy for that time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but then I know I think myself. This is just no, and also next time this not like we this. Just time next time I want to win here. Foreign fighter, I make my India proud, my country proud. But August, next September, in Bangalore, I'm meeting the Iranian guy. He's the Iranian Olympian boxer. I'm meeting him in the same semi-final fight. But this time I won for him. Next, I'm going to that in so many matches, more than I thought. In my career, I fought more than 100 fights. After that, and also I have a gym. My gym name is Everlast Brave, because this gym helped me a lot, because my gym support me, because I found my gym and I make lot of fighters. Lot of fighters, now they are in a good position. One guy working in that school for the physical education teacher, and one guy is in the police department. Another, so many guys, they have different direction, but they are
mm-hmm.
good now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they, yes. I made 20 state level champions and 4 national gold medalists, and some people they are, and also fitness also. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But my gym helped me because I don't have any sponsor, frankly. I'll get money for me into that participate match and my protein, everything. I earn money for my gym. That money, I take that money for, you know, my expenses for training.
Mm.
Yeah. Then I make my make the student and my fighting and my and concentrate with my student training. After a while, I get I have, you know, badly. Yeah, I thought in 2016 November. Yeah, I do one video shoot. Accidentally, I try one kick. Accidentally, my knee is slipping. I got a ACL ligament injury.
That was for a video recording.
Video recording.
I didn't know that. Oh, I thought it was a competition. Okay.
Yeah. mark this. But 2016, my knee is badly injured. Everybody say you can't walk. You go to the rest and you go to hospital, go to surgery. But but this is, I want to mention it because I'm also Varimakalai martial artist. Varimakalai is a very old martial art. I thought it's a very, very old, like,
yeah, that's the ancient Indian
ancient, like, it's originated and also Kung Fu like that. Because
more people have heard about Kalari, but there's
Varimakalai. Yeah, it's a Bodhi Dharma, he's practicing Varimakalai. Yeah.
Bodhidharma, the one who went to Shaolin later in China.
Yeah.
So he was also known as Damo in China.
Yeah. He's a founder of Shaolin.
Yeah.
I am practicing Varimakalai and till 2010. Then I know Varimakalai is healing and also the self defense moves we have. But I am looking, and then I go back my teachers and try to heal my injuries. But everybody say go and take rest. Don't push your knees. You need good rest. That time yoga helped me. You know, I have another master in yoga. He's a very expert. His name is Annadurai. And also, he also do some asanas and some moves. And I changed my ways path. And also at that time I can't if you're not active in physically, you act mentally.
Mm.
Yeah, I trigger my mental.
Mm.
Yeah, I wrote one book for ancient traditional master. After a while, my student he talked to me. I say I want to be rest in Chennai is not good rest for me, and also I want to do Varimakalai. I'm interested to teach Varimakalai. He say, master, if you want to teach Varimakalai, I have a good place for that. He introduced me to Auroville.
Ah,
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
His name is Sai. He introduced me to Auroville. Before I don't know about Auroville.
Mm-hmm.
I think 2016, first time I'm hearing Auroville. He explained everything.
What a coincidence, because this is actually exactly the same time when we also got introduced from a different angle to Auroville.
Yeah. Yeah. Then
2016.
Yeah, he take me in Auroville, and first time I entered the Auroville, totally, you know, that place, you know, I don't know, I have a different feel for that place. I know that place, you know, make me feel good, and you know, I need to stay there like that. I need to do something for here, because this place, you know, we have some different feeling for, you know, I started for one traditional martial arts center only, not boxing, not MMA, not like that. No one know me. Auroville local people, they think I'm a yoga master. They think I'm a very ordinary guy.
They think you are a yoga master because you're doing Varimakalai.
Yeah, Varimakalai. Yeah. I'm a yoga master, I'm a Selama master, I'm a very soft guy, I'm a very soft nut.
It seems that Varimakalai has the same image problems like Tai Chi, right? It's not recognized as a martial art? No, it is.
No, it's a martial art.
Yeah, no, I mean, if it's recognized as one. When the people think that you are, they placed you in this yoga.
But it's not like karate and kung fu like that.
Yeah,
maybe
know,
you,
are, yeah,
maybe
yeah.
you are right.
Mm.
It's not karate and kung fu like that.
Mm.
But Varimakalai, most of the people, they can't learn because Varimakalai is a hidden martial art. Because teacher, frankly, they are not willing to teach others.
Mm.
They say this is secret art.
Mm.
There are a lot of secret moves is there.
Mm.
But, you know, every art if we're not willing to teach, that art is going to, you know, that's not
die out.
Yeah, maybe like that.
Yeah.
Because if I learn something, I have to teach that for others, because that's my duty, you know.
Yeah.
Because knowledge is not mine.
Yeah.
I take what someone give me, and I give for.
Mm.
There is a fair. But and Auroville, you know, then I stay more than 6 months in Auroville. That place introduced me Michael, and you know, one day in a Sadhana forest, I walk in that forest, I saw one light lamp moving, just you know, that's very mystery. I thought any what is there? I'm very shocked. What is there like that? You know, some horror movie like that. Yeah.
That's really funny, because in reality it was my wife. She practiced form with a headlight because she was afraid of snakes and stuff. So for her this was also a horror scenario, but from the other side.
Yeah.
Okay.
Then I know. I talk with her. She say I am doing Tai Chi. I am doing this regular. And afterward, I enter that arts in that area, big area. I met another guy. He's also doing same Tai Chi, but that before I met that that woman, she is in that forest, but he is not in the forest. He is in very bright room, you know. But then I talk to him, he say, yes, I do Tai Chi. Then he say, yes, we are husband and wife. We
so he's talking about myself.
yeah. And you know, then I get a very good friend for Michael. Yeah, he's very good, very nice guy. And I also there I'm trying to you know make try to teach the people and I conduct the free camps and lot of activity and go everywhere and do demonstration and do some adventures also, you know. One day I wrestled with a bull in some forest.
Yeah. I also did this. I did the Goshala, the cow sanctuary for a while, and there were some times where I also used some Taiji skills with the bulls. There was before Happy got castrated. He was not castrated this time. It was interesting.
After that, make me very sad because after that I think why I'll do that? You know,
the castration.
Okay,
but this is a different topic now. I also felt very good about this.
Because if I not control that cow is going to free. I am the one reason to control that cow. Then at Sadhana, I am, that place is also, I like that place and to stay there in very peaceful and you know, quite very interesting to meet the new peoples and different knowledge we got there.
Different mindsets.
Mindset, yeah. Oh. Yeah. And different good vibration is there. Yeah. After a while, I have a call for Chennai, here I have a gym and a lot of students looking for me. They are waiting for me. They are waiting for their master. I have two thinking. One is, Pondicherry or Chennai, but finally Chennai is when.
It's your home also, right?
Yeah.
Your local.
Yeah. I decided to move on Chennai. I'm come here and then I make my I'm regular my training, and also I got a chance for acting in that movie Red Rooster, that movie names, in that lead role.
Red Rooster.
Red Rooster. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, in Tamil movie.
So check the video, the Red Rooster, the movie.
That movie, one action role. Unfortunately, I got injured for my knee again. So that this time very badly. My knee is dislocated. It's not come back again. It's separated. That night I'm disappointed. But next day I'm going to know. Set my knees again, but this pain is make me very horrible. You know, very very huge pain I have. Then I have decided to, because this is my life. You know, we have only one life. We don't know we are born again or not. But if the one life we have to use to achieve more, because we life want to say something to the people, you know. I am the master artist. I am the fighter. I am adventure. This is me. I am not a quiet guy. I am not a come to for peace. Yeah, I'm come to for peace, but in this way, because
you're not looking for a comfortable life. You want to say, right?
In my career, in my life, I know martial art make me very good habit, because I'm not. I have no any bad habits. Yes, I'm a teetotal like that, because I want to thanks to that martial art, because this art make me good.
So to clarify, bad habits, you mean no smoking, no drinking,
nothing,
drugs,
nothing
which can grab
for my
anything.
Birth, nothing. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know. I don't like that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Then I go to surgery my knee, because I have two options, because you also have a knee problem, because you don't surgery, because doctor say if you not surgery, okay, you will walk and you do it, but you can't do your sports, because your combat sports more dangerous. But I have two options: want to be coacher, want to be quiet myself, want to be fighter and with coacher. Okay, I selected a second one because I quit my career because I feel I have energy in my inside. I don't want to be waste my energy for one injury. Okay, this injury not stop me. I'm surgery my knee and my doctor is a very good motivator and he say 6 months you will do any sports. He give 100% guarantee for me.
Mm-hmm.
Then I boosted. Surgery is done. Last November. Now today is I think July 11th. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Now our life give lot of surprise every day, every minute. If we work hard, we get surprise. Yeah, the surprise happened for my life. Last month I went Haryana. I'm not quite there for the kickboxing national seminar. You know, every day I'm trying. Every day in the old stadium, I'm run and I'm do lot of heavy workouts. And also I'm teach some local people in there. For the National Federation, Kickboxing Federation of India, looking me if I my hard work, my every activity. And also they are knowing me, okay, I'm a settled fighter. Then in the general body meeting, they announced me in the Tamil Nadu State General Secretary for Kickboxing. I got the posting for Tamil Nadu State in that kickboxing. Now I have a responsibility to promote kickboxing in Tamil Nadu and conduct the matches and made lot of talenters. No, before I'm a king like that, now I'm a king maker like that. And also I'm not retired. still I want to be king. And last couple of days I thought maybe I went in Delhi in that MMA national match. At the same time I'm going for the judge and referee and I bring my student. They got silver medal. And my meeting, another surprise I have, they give me that second association. IMA, All India Mixed Martial Arts Federation, is a very big federation, MMA federation in India. They conduct a lot of pro fighting and they make a lot of career for the athletes. They post me in Tamil Nadu State Secretary for MMA. Now I have two posting for two different big association. And this surprise I got because I hope my activity, my, you know, if I do something for my, you know, any, it's something I can do, that way they are select me for this, you know. Now I have a very big responsibility to make the career to the local peoples. I want to be ordinary people to extraordinary level. You know, before, you know, I am searching for that opportunity. Now mm-hmm. I get it.
Mm-hmm.
And also now I make it.
Mm-hmm.
Now I want to give that opportunity for that coming generation.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And at the same time, people, you asking the question for me. I'm hearing your mind voice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you ask. Now you have everything. You are the position. You can make match. You can do anything. Why you are fighting? Because I'm fighting. I know fighting is dangerous. Is injuries because, but if I'm doing fighting, I'm inspiring few peoples. If I'm inspiring, they're ready to. They come for sports. They change their habit. You know, if they are going to the bad way, then they are changing because. I give that some example because I say I'm like this, that way I do this, you know.
Mm-hmm.
That way I take it. And Michael also say, I thought yesterday, you don't want to be fight because your coach is good for, but you know, but.
And we're talking about real fights and injuries happen.
Yeah,
so
you say.
We're talking about a situation when we watched a video and then all of a sudden there was one move which was very powerful and. Oh, we saw that the guy was actually immediately was sorry, but the man was a ring. So,
yeah.
And I was just considering as from a martial art perspective, other than a sport perspective, in the end we don't want that anything is happening at all.
Oh. Yeah, but the real situations, people need motivations. You know, in the present world, fight is no need, because fight is not a solution. Fight is, you know, violence is the beginning of every problems.
Yeah.
Violence create problem. Violence not, you know, destiny.
Yeah.
Is the beginning for everything. Once violence start, is very difficult to control. You know, but fight is not outside. Fight is our inner side. Because if I'm sure, give that I'm sure, 100% sure, give tell that surely tell this. In that brave man do one mistake, coward man do 99% mistake, maybe an 100% mistake.
Mm.
You know, there is no danger for brave man. For example, in army, in police department, you know, the commando is the brave man. Coward man is not a commando.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a soldier, but they're not at anyone, you know, they save people.
Mm.
You know? That is the bravery, you know. Martial art give the bravery.
Brave.
Yeah, combat sports, the fighting give a braveness. Mm. Courageous. Yeah.
So you want to say we need to be brave in order to be able to do the right thing.
Yeah, that's why my gym name is Everlast Brave.
Yeah, Everlast Brave. Yeah.
Brave forever and live healthy. And I just want to tell everyone, please do martial art.
Yeah, this was actually a very, maybe we can pronounce this again, that this is really well understood. I think this is a very, very important, valid point, that we need to get brave, we need to be strong in order to be able to do the right thing, or to even to follow a divine path or whatever. So, and everybody's talking always about the connection between spirituality and martial arts, and a lot of things are made up, but I think here we have a very practical, a real, it's a necessity.
Yes.
Just recently my wife, she read with Oshiro Aurobindo, by the way.
Okay.
Which is the background about Orwell. And the mother, so the two, and she read about we need to become very stable, we need to get a very stable center, we need to get independent of everything which is happening, whatever. We cannot, just like the flag in the wind, we must be very stable. What we do, how we think, it's so much determined by what is coming to us. Before we cannot do that, we can even not dedicate our life truly to the divine. So, yeah, I think also martial art really.
Yeah, martial art is
really
a
helps for
divine.
The,
yes,
the,
martial art
for developing this.
Yes,
this
it's a spiritual. Yeah.
Yeah.
For example, Shaolin monks. Yeah, Shaolin monks is a very good example for discipline. They are the martial artist. Their lifestyle: meditate, prayer, working, training, rest, then pray, meditation. See, they are following their life. They are very strong and they are very confident, and they live very healthy.
Mm.
You know, they have no any you know, they not suffer for anything. But we we have a lot of suffer. We have money, we have everything, we have everything, but we are suffering.
Yeah.
Because, see, our life is want to be do different thing. You know, if you this is Zen Buddhism. If you play like a child. If you play, if you eat like a child.
Mm-hmm.
If you sleep like a child. Don't be a grown human. Because our, you know, thought is everything. What do you think we become, you know? And be, think yourself, and you are a, we are the human for, you know, we are the human for, you know, I don't get the exact word.
I can try it in Tamil.
But
I can't translate this Tamil.
No, it's okay. Yeah, we are the human.
We have this potential. We are very complex. The problems which you described, they came because we are so complex. We have so much desires that we suffer. But the monk lifestyle is a very simple lifestyle.
Yeah.
And but there's also the potential
but
to set ourselves
is,
free.
One
so
thing
have,
is very difficult. If I'm say, it's very difficult to live like a monster because, you know, monk they are not chasing for money, but we not like that. We are chasing for our every day. We chasing our money. Our life is going to competitions. Yeah. You know, in for birth, our childhood, we start our competition for school, for examination, for work, in the designation, for family, in the love and affections, for old age, for caring, but till end we have a, you know, we you know we chasing for.
Security, actually, we are afraid of losing everything. And,
yeah, suffering, yeah. This is my, this is Mike and me, and I want to be tell myself. It's not a interview for that, you know. This is our, you know, our.
Common ground.
So
I think for me also the martial arts was a possibility also to this type of training to train to get more the simpler life to train a center that becomes non-moving center a stable center to get rid of a lot of fears and also false desires. I used to talk about the distinguishing of the real needs, the bare necessities, and the false desires. Just if you can sort out this, a lot of this unnecessary suffering is already done. And yeah, maybe up to the point where we can completely free our mind and free our spirit and all understand. So then we can realize more and more that there is actually nothing to fear or nothing to suffer at all.
Yeah.
Because what I see as a daddy, by the way, that these things which you pointed out, you grew up with competition, to me become very clear also because of living in Savannah Forest, which is a very uncompetitive place. So, and the whole idea of Oro is actually to transform all of that also, but not in the monk way of living, just in a more normal way of living. But as a, in the role now as a daddy, I experience very, very clearly how all of these things is not naturally given, it's educated. We transmit those bad habits, things, and these mindsets, and the kids they start to do that because they see it from us.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it would be different. So to get back to this pure state of a childhood, you were mentioning it already.
Yeah.
Sleep like a play like a child, sleep like a child. So yeah, it's part of the thing. And this we can do in our arts. That's why we do the arts. This we love the arts.
Yeah.
Actually, there's no further reason. We can also say very simply, we do them because we love them, right? And there's some desire, but there's an inspiration, there's a connection. So we talked about a lot of things actually, which is connected to that, which makes it way more interesting than just about having some sports. So it goes deeper.
Yeah, and we have a lot of plan here, and
yeah, maybe I want to recommend when you're in Chennai, nearby Chennai, you're looking for some martial art training. Please check him out, Brave.
Everlast Brave.
Everlast Brave. And we also placed the link, of course, to your gym and to your place. What I found there was a very ideal atmosphere and mentality in your students, which is reflecting definitely your good work, which you did, and then really openness. Usually martial artists, they're, when they have their path already, they're not so open that they just allow other teachers to come and fool around with their students. But I was invited to do so, and it was a pleasure for me. And I think that you're really always looking for the best for your students and for yourself.
Yes.
And you're very open-minded, looking for new challenges and further development, because a true art never ends. It's a refinement to the end. And,
I hope.
So this mindset you will find there. So
I hope
to come there.
You know, Michael is in Chinese martial arts, doing Kung Fu, Tai Chi. But I never do Kung Fu, Tai Chi before.
Mm.
No, I'm different. But you know, I have some knowledge. I'm understanding. Every martial art is the same. We are the family. You know, it's our own body. We have different body part. It's like, you know, in eye is a kung fu, our ear is a karate, our mouth is a judo, our, you know, like this. But our art is same, you know.
Okay.
Yeah. That I am strongly believe. You know, that way, you know, my thought is every people learn martial art. Whatever you learn Wing Chun, you learn Tai Chi, you learn Kung Fu, Karate, Judo, and Varimakalai, I am very good for field because but every martial art is, people must learn martial art, because martial art is teach only how to live life good, how to make your health good, how to make your mind control in good way. You know, every martial art is this, you know, none other martial art teach you any bad things.
Mm. Yeah, if it's a true art, then it should be like that. Yes.
That why people must learn martial art, because another thing, this is my friend, he's not an Indian guy. I'm not a German guy. But I want to be share this. If there are people coming in India, if you think, okay, if we going for in yoga studio, yes, I'm recommended, because I love yoga. I'm studying yoga in university. But at the same time, you go into for Indian traditional art. It's like a silamam. It's an Indian traditional art. You can get it in South India. You can get it in Tamil Nadu. In Kalari is a Indian art. You can get it in Kerala. You can get it in Narkoil, Kanyakumari, in south side, in Varimakalai. Yes, Varimakalai is a very special art. Is so many things you have to know. It's a very surprising. If you go to learn, you get very surprised. You will go and get it. And not only that, in north side, in different kind of in the kusti, the traditional wrestling, you can go and get. It's very very good for fitness, and you have a very good self confidence. Yeah, there is a lot of different art in India. Please go and search in Google and know about that. And if you come in India, go and make plan for that. Not only looking for, please don't looking for only yoga studio.
And also look for, because
Tai Chi.
I would say in general.
Yeah, it's very good. Tai Chi master, yeah.
Master, no. I'm just a local instructor of Chinese Tai Chi Quan practical methods. No, but going for something, also Google research, yeah, we can check everything, but then also look for real persons who have, like we, I mean, maybe not the big master skill for myself, I can only talk, but we have something, and that's, I think, is also our common ground. We have the same aspiration in this, to go for something real, not some fancy flowery things in the mind, so that is substantial and really usable. And all these qualities, I believe they come also through when we're talking about all the other usages in life, or what's the purpose of it, especially when the martial art we are training, also yoga when it's a good one, but it must be real.
Yeah.
And therefore you need to be people who have the transmission and not only the books or the videos.
Yeah. Sometimes this is very, you know, yeah, one day I want to say this. I'm in that boxing match in one university, SRM University. There is some boxers. They announce some boxers. My, they are fighting with my students. They are lost. After that, they come to meet me. Sir, you are very good. You make very good boxers, and you are a very good coacher. Please give your contact. I want to learn with you. I say, okay. You are always welcome. Then he opening that mind. He's mine. He tell me, sir. I ask him, where you learn boxing? Who is your master? Like that. So, no master, sir. I don't have a master. I just learn for boxing in YouTube.
Okay, another example. Okay.
Shock. Why? What? YouTube? Yes, sir. I just watch YouTube videos, and then I try with my friends. And directly I'm coming to the boxing match. Now I'm getting it. I lost. Now I understand. YouTube is not good for me. I'll come with you. Please teach me the proper boxing.
Okay.
You know, it's happening, you know. See, you can't learn any art for video or any books. That's the only reference.
Yeah, it's an additional help, and you can pick up a lot of things.
If you already know that, if you're not practicing, you are forgetting. You go and watch that, then you can recall.
Yeah,
that's only that good. But otherwise, you have mastered for physically.
Yeah.
You know, go on. Because, and also you will looking if you want to get a master, please, yeah, always don't search in the Google. Go and directly feel it, you know,
approach people. And also comparing is a good, I mean, as a beginner we always think, and it's also good to think that we cannot judge, and also to be non-judgmental. Judging is always a little tricky, but if you go to different places and to different people, comparison is possible. And then it's about to find a connection, a personal connection. It's not necessarily about having the guy with the best skill or how. Anyway, we cannot really rank that. But yeah, look for something real, something authentic. Authenticism is very important.
Yeah. Another thing is have any question?
I think we talked also a lot. It's a 3/4 of an hour.
Okay.
This wants to be edited. but everything is recorded, yeah. Nice. Yeah, shall we close?
Yeah.
We'll just say. So, thank you for watching. Hope that there was some inspiring words there for you, and to give you some insights, and also to introduce.
Some interesting word for that very quiet knowledge we have, you know, we are a very simple man. I am a very simple man, thanks for Michael to
thanks for
make interview me, and thanks for watching everyone. You are a very good passion to watch
all of this. Yes.
Yeah.
Very likely we will not be able to edit it, so you just post it like it is.
Yeah. Because
so when you reach to this point, then definitely you must come to our classes.
Yeah. And also please don't forget your laughing. Yes, laughing is a very good medicine.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
We love to laugh, and you also.
Yeah.
And thank you very much once again.
Yeah, thank you. Okay.